and see a neighbour. Or phone an old friend that you haven't seen for it. Or write a letter to a friend. And people who say they're bored drive me potty. How can you be bored? There's so much to do. So I said, you can't be bored. You cannot be. You've got the wrong word. Then he says, they're bored. I said, right, well, then you're boring. You must be very boring to be bored. There's so much you can do. You can go out and help somebody who's worse off than you are. And then you won't be bored again. You'll realise how lucky you are.
Does that cheer them up?
Not always, no. Some go away and commit suicide, but, you know. ...off than you are. And then you won't be bored again. You'll realise how lucky you are.
Does that cheer them up?
Not always, no. Some go away and commit suicide, but, you know, you can't win them all. And then you won't be bored again. You'll realise how lucky you are.
Does that cheer them up?
Not always, no. Some go away and commit suicide, but, you know, you can't win them all. He's worse off than you are. And then you won't be bored again. You'll realise how lucky you are.
Does that cheer them up?
Not always, no. Some go away and commit suicide, but, you know, you can't win them all.
There we go. Hello. I wasn't speaking and then I ruined the the number of times I've seen that over the last 24 hours. Anyway, hello. Welcome to a brand new day of this thing, whatever this is. Hey, Tobes, Tom, Matty, Dogface Boy Dave. I haven't actually got a dog face. Right. I mean, let's just kick off, shall we? Greetings from Cape Town. Well, hello, Darth Vader. That's just because I have no idea what this is going to be. Let's just... So, yeah, how are we all doing today, anyway? In this crazy mixed-up world. Okay, that's fine. We can have that. Hey Dan, how you doing? The ever popular unlabeled I love the unlabeled tapes. Because they could be anything. You know. Hey, no worries, man. You know, as much as I welcome the chat and I love the chat, if people want to just lurk. As I know a lot of people do, you know, I sometimes look at the chat list and I see there's people who haven't spoken, and I feel bad, for a long time I would kind of look at that and go, oh, hi, so-and-so, and I think people just don't like, I don't know, I felt bad about it in retrospect, because I think, if people are just sat there not chatting, you don't want to out them, but hello to any lurkers, you are very welcome to do so. You'll be playing Crash Bandicoot Remastered. Hey, Rob. Not working today, so only just woke up. Beautiful. Yeah, I'm working Tuesday and Wednesday this week. Thursday and Friday, I booked off because it's my mum's 60th on Saturday or Sunday next week, the 29th, whichever one that is. And they were all meant to be coming to London. That is a snazzy way of listing my Twitter, etc. Yeah. As I said before yesterday several times, Alex, Mercy and Media. On Twitter, he came up with this just apropos of nothing. Good, just tinkering around on Doom Eternal. I don't think I've played that much. I don't think I've really played any Doom games to any length. You know, I've got so many games to play. I've been playing Animal Crossing, but also Octopath Traveler is currently half price on the Switch eShop. So I finally caved in and bought that. So I've got all of that to play. And I've got about 100 games on my Switch that I've just barely played. You're playing Animal Crossing too. I mean, do add me as a. I'll if you follow me on the Twitter, I'll put up my friend code after the stream. So, Animal Crossing, it's. I won't lie, it won't be for everyone. I'm still not quite sure it's for me. Despite, this is my second Animal Crossing game. It's chill. It is very chill. There's nothing that could possibly kill you, apart from the stress of the debt. I'm live, SPW. Can you see or hear me? Everyone else seems to. Not a big gamer, but Halo Collection for a tenner yesterday. Yeah, I mean, those are meant to be really good. Logged over 1,000 hours on the 3DS. I mean, that's hardcore. I've already cheated a bit on Animal Crossing Switch. I did sort of just hop forward a day, just in order to get some better, to like get things like the shovel and things, which, I mean, Ollie, who sometimes drops in on here, Boglet Hermit, he's managed to get all sorts of things just by grinding. My resource management was piss poor. I think I sold things I shouldn't have sold, and I was bad at getting all the stuff from the stones, because if you don't bed yourself in, you can only get a couple of bits from stones. I forgot about the two hole trick, but so I did time travel a couple of days. Now, I will say, I forgot to clean the VCR yesterday, so I hope. I mean, the outage bill, I mean, that's not suitable, is it? Still hopeful. I'm pretty sure there will be some ads, so. Ooh, Amityville Horror. Yeah, I. Mind you, I mean, as I said before, gore is fine. It's an ad channel. Thank you, Dave. Yeah, I really should put add a little credit there for Alex, because. Yeah, it's a channel with ads because I've only rewound about half an hour. So either the film cuts out after 20 minutes, or because when I pressed play, it was an ad break. So. But yeah, more likely to be doing these kind of daytime streams when my mum's working. Well, I'm not playing a tape.
So people use them, you know.
Yeah, no, it's not a coincidence, Tobe. Someone mentioned this a couple of streams ago. Because of the Twitch doesn't it doesn't like the randomness of the static, basically. So when it's dealing with that, it struggles to deal with me in proper resolution. Yes, I saw the Thames logo in there somewhere as well. I need to start recording because this is what we're all here for. We're all here for the ads. Don't just watch the ads. Oh, no, do just watch the ads. Hey Claire, I hope you're not bored today. Only boring people are bored. I mean. As I said at the start of the stream, I was playing that clip over and over. I've seen it many times now.
This is Marcello Gandini, and
Yes,
this is his work,
oh, I mean,
which
Tobes,
begs the question,
Tobes,
what
no,
does the
we're not
Lamborghini
saying
designer
it.
drive to Lamborghini?
Nothing
Naturally, he
happened.
chooses one of his
Hey,
own
Chris. Hey,
designs,
Nelly,
the
how you doing?
Citroën EX. Beneath Signor Gandini's sleek exterior beats a heart with 16 valves.
This is
It can
some
take this
calm music.
BX
This is
from 0
furniture
to 60
stalling.
in less than 7.5 seconds. The car is capable of 135 miles an hour, but today, all this machismo is not for much
help. I'm pretty much on days when I'm not working, when I have to look at news.
Citroen BX, do you enjoy getting to work as much?
Not look at news at all. I'll look at the headlines when I feel like it. Can I help you, sir?
The balance on my instant extra account, please.
Oh, just brilliant. Type in your details. I'm glad you're here, SPW. I will say there's several streams now that I've not... several streams now that I've not uploaded to YouTube, so you've got more catching up to do, but stay here for this. I think
you'll enjoy high interest and instant access.
We're having good days and bad days, and that's going to continue. Because you can't.
We'd like Hoover to recommend our ferry automatic.
Oh, for God's sake, guys!
I don't know if Hoover would recommend a non-buyer.
Lots of people use them, you know.
It's terrific at low temperatures. I mean, red hot.
It won't touch.
Is that better?
It does.
Or black currant.
That too.
I guess because every, I don't know, maybe it's because every video audio is different.
But you're in for a long wait.
Maybe the microphone is slightly further away. Yeah. Excellent. I'm glad.
It passed all the tests.
It's just a frustrating thing.
Congratulations.
But there's no one setting which just works from stream to stream. That was quite a short ad break. Let's not watch the scary film. I don't like the scary film. Actually, I'm not sensitive to horror, but I've never been a fan. It's never really been a genre I've enjoyed. Also, this is a complete mess, my folder, at this point. Having just gone through it and cleaned it up, late last week, it's now gone back to being, 30 migrate video files. Yeah, Nelly, it's... That's often the case, that the last advert just freezes. You've never understood the point of horror films. Why deliberately do you... I mean... I'm actually working with a decent amount of hard drive space. I think I've still got about 400 gigs. And I've got my external hard drive with me, which I need to back stuff up onto. Which is about 300... I've got about one... I think I've got about 1.5 terabytes left on there. Hey, Rich. How you doing, man? I guess people like being scared, I think, Tobes. I mean, you know, they've just never really done it for me. They don't really scare me. They just bore me. Horror films, to be honest. I think, it's exactly the adrenaline rush. And, you know, I get it, but it's just, See, I don't like roller coasters or bungee jumping, Dave, so... I'm the wrong person here, but yeah. Yeah, I mean, I dare say we're probably a long way from the light at the end of the tunnel at the moment, but you're right, every day is a step towards it. That's what we're ultimately marching on. Ew. Yeah, no worries, Dan. As I say, people are free to lurk, and they're free to engage as much as they like. It's all cool. Most horror films are bad, and then you'll have jump scares. Yeah, quite possible. A lot of modern ones are quite predictable, though. I mean, I love a good B movie. you know, the kind of thing you'd get on Mystery Science Theatre. Even then, I don't tend to watch them without the riffs, you know. God, camera film, remember that, eh? How cool, I've got Never Dudley Moore. I don't know how many of those there were. I've already got two quite different ones in that series. Are Kodak still going a strong, Claire? I mean, I'm not a camera person, so I don't. My brother-in-law was big in film. I have my own Twitter account, which is at Pete D. Trenchard. I only have one account for this, but I have my personal one where I just kind of, yeah. Now the comedy course.
Something strange and wonderful is happening.
Oh, Colin!
From far above the planet,
hey Jeff, how you
ESB doing? Is beaming down its five themed channels. There's sport.
Must be about movies, 1990 this state,
arts,
yeah.
Comedy and music.
Colin?
British television
British
will never be the same.
I can barely do any impression.
The trouble is, if you're not connected, you won't even know it's there.
BSB, that's old, yeah.
BSB, five-channel TV. You watch, we listen.
Well, that's show business, folks.
Gosh.
Gosh, you know, it's one of those ads. Lots of kids with white teeth and giant shoulder pads. It's not a dream from those crazy eggs because it's made right here. You know it's tougher than tanks.
Made in Scotland.
Man, yeah, don't worry, yeah. Look, chat, I'm good with people doing whatever makes them happy. Or at least makes
if your production process is falling apart,
more comfortable.
Get an expert to help you get it right. The Enterprise Initiative.
That was a really good answer, 500-200.
See the great productions at the Argos Summer Sale before they disappear? Argos takes care of it.
Oh, that's because the thing. Yeah. Yes, it seems unwise to watch the Amityville Horror on stream. But let's just deal with the microphone issue. I'll just whack myself up a decibel. The problem is, because this isn't a desk, so I'm not kind of under the desk. This is my mum's dresser table that I've got my laptop resting on. Isn't it ITV if it's Thames, Tom? Right, I've whacked myself off a bit. Just back from taking your dad home some shopping, sat down to find this live, brilliant. Well, you are very welcome, Rebel Gerald. I've not long started. Next time someone vomits, they'll cut to the head. Right, let's stop that recording and it's a weird thing, it's a really nice sunny day out there today. I just popped across the road to go to the post box, and it's very sunny and warm, and you're like, part of me wants to go out, but you can't really. I mean, you can go out a bit, but you know. It happens, Jomond. Hi. But yeah, my mum's working till 4. I mean, this is the thing, when my mum's working, I'm more likely to do a daytime stream than an evening stream. Because, you know, I feel, I, not an obligation, I feel like I should be, I feel like it's a bit antisocial to be coming up here and doing this for sort of several hours. I might do some short evening ones as time goes on. Mum suggested to go to the park, you know, we wouldn't do that in March when things are normal. But yeah, I mean, that's fair enough. But yeah, this week I'm only working Tuesday and Wednesday. We might be doing some things with my sister, but then my sister's very cagey about stuff at the moment. It's like, oh, I don't know. Yeah. I mean, to be honest, Dan, today I'm actually feeling all right. I've barely looked at the news. I've only played I've played a bit of Animal Crossing. Yeah, it comes and goes. It's in waves. Today I'm all right. Tomorrow I might be absolutely bricking it and, you know, miserable. But right here, right now, I'm all right. And those are the times when I think it's most important for me to do stuff like this, because hopefully, you know, I can do this, some of this can just rub off on you guys. Oh, nice one, Dan. I'm glad. Did you get some sleep last night? I know you've been struggling.
Right, boys, Tommy, that's the number one single of What You Untold Riches.
Don't know.
Wow.
Mr. Durangelo, our manager.
I mean, I've seen adverts with Harry Enfield before, quite a few of them, but
haven't got one of these.
Is this
then
two Harry Enfield?
Oh, it's an NatWest Card Plus account. Lets you get your money 24 hours a day.
Oh, mega dosha.
Let's see two Harry Enfields.
Oh.
Oh, nice.
Dislodge the brain cell, I hope. Now watch carefully.
I don't. I'm not watching the PM Stady conference script.
Mr.
Durangelo.
Hello, boys. Fancy bumping into you.
What's all this then?
It's my.
Oh, it's this Rainbow George's neighbour.
Boys,
nobody knows his name, but he's Rainbow George's neighbour.
Boys, I was going to open an account for you anyway.
I can't do it, Chris. Hi. Yeah, sometimes they're positive, sometimes they're not. Either way,
it's just business.
Long?
A month.
That's long.
I called round last night. You had company.
You mean my brother? Came round for coffee.
Brother.
Golden roasted, richer,
Giles.
Smoother. Nescafe.
Yeah, Rainbow
Gold
George's
blend.
Mate. He's always banging on about him.
I forgot to say, I'll be in New York.
I hope you remember to take some gold blend with you.
So you might like to know I'm staying at the Plaza.
Was gold blend any good? I don't drink coffee. But it gets really overhyped in those adverts. I mean, I know adverts are meant to overhype stuff, but well, do tell us, Claire. Coffee shaggers, yeah. Yeah, I've got a few of the gold blend ones already.
Sports coverage that makes waves. Wake
I've got
up
some of the Sherry Lundy coffee adverts and some of the Giles coffee adverts.
Welcome on, let's go, let's go, let's go, little
get up and go with Renault this summer. Go for the Renault Famous Fives with 0% finance. Go for the special edition Renault 19 Sport.
Really?
It's got the same offer going for it.
That is Anthony had the same Nescafe adverts in America.
Get up and
fun.
Go for power with the Renault 21.
Complete like for like reshots then.
Go for luxury from the Renault 25. And if it's versatility you're after, the Renault Espace has got more going for it.
For more of everything,
get up and go to your Renault dealer.
I mean, surely part of his appeal in America is that he's this kind of erudite Englishman, you know, a sort of suave Hugh Grant type. They're boxy, but they're good. I sure love quaffy. Oh, Joey! How you doing? Oh, almost certainly have YouTube, yeah. Wow.
We opened that West Carl Plaza account so you get a free album from WH Smiths.
Well, one of your own?
Yeah.
No, don't know.
Wicked.
I've got to say, these are some damn good adverts. Stop recording there so we all don't get really scared. Yeah, I tend to now just wait for the Prime Minister's thing to be over, and then I just look at the news headlines and go, oh, okay. Boom, yeah. What have you boomed?
It's the hell out of me.
Taster's choice, right, okay.
Thank you.
Let's see if I can just get us this a minute. I don't know how well this will work, but let's... Hang on, have I got anything incriminating on? No, I haven't, that's fine. Bear with me a second. Why is that not giving me Chrome? Well, that's frustrating. See, I'd like to be able to show stuff like that on.
Thank you for a lovely dinner.
You know, if people send, because people do obviously link to YouTube things, and that's really cool. Maybe display capture? I guess. No, that's... Okay, anyway, that's not going to work, and maybe this is something I'll try again off stream. But yeah, no, it's all right, Gareth. I was trying to experiment with things, and it wasn't.
The door that was broken out with Mr. Lutz from the inside.
Anyway,
burglars break in. You've got a front door that's broken out.
Let me tell you something.
Oh, sorry, was that your? Was that your inopportune moment to come into the stream? Hello, Gareth. How are you, man? Once again, I imagine this is always going to be the case for these afternoon streams. Once again, Charlie is just zonked out of the bed behind me. The other cat, Louie, I think is in my mum's room. He kind of keeps himself to himself a lot during the day. Had to visit Dan TDM for a second at the insistence of my kids. I mean, that's disgraceful. Have an optimism today. I think there's a lot. There's a few of us who are feeling kind of all right today, which is nice. Let's hang on to that one. Yeah, I did think of sort of, I was like, is it possible for me to try, you know, because I can cut down on the swearing and things, but the problem, I can never really advertise this as a family-friendly stream, because I don't know what's going to be on the tapes, you know. Yeah, I was thinking about that last night. I'm like, you know, it would be nice if I could advertise that, but the nature, because, you know, lots of parents are at home and things. But I guess the nature of the tape thing means I never really can. You woke up thinking we're living through a moment. I mean,
I'm blind.
Yeah, I can't say I've experienced quite that, Gareth. But then again, when the BBC was saying about all the things they're going to do, I had that moment. Hey, Becky, how you doing? I had that moment from a kind of TV geek perspective of going, well, this is going to be really cool to watch. You know, new BBC sports programming, the exercise program, all this special stuff. You know, I even tuned into a bit of Question Time for the fact that it was a different setup and it was, you know, and it was on at 8 o'clock and all this stuff.
Strongbow. Nothing else quite hits the mark.
There is definitely a uniqueness to what we're doing, to what's going on at the moment.
Now you don't need an undercoat. With Solo.
Oh,
from
wow, okay. I'm not a diarist,
the rules.
Yeah. Hey, Katie.
In just half a minute from now, you'll have an interesting choice to
yeah,
make.
Yeah, I wish I hadn't watched Question Time. It, you know, don't get me wrong, it was depressing as hell.
And any one of eight speciality medium pizzas while you're watching the World Cup on TV or in a Pizza Hut restaurant,
the
escape
from the
World Cup
to
on
it,
TV.
The novelty of it,
the choice, as always with Pizza Hut, is yours. Pizza Hut Great Save. Two people.
Well,
$7.99
to be honest, Tom,
until July
I imagine 15th. The Amityville Horror isn't exactly a daytime film. You know? I feel like that should have been the initial tip-off that this would be a late-night showing. And now, children's BBC, the Amityville Horror. They'll be talking about this. So, I mean, the problem is they're all in London, most of my tapes. I have actually bought, I think, 40 new tapes, just to give me a bit of a buffer space, because after getting through three or four of them yesterday, I'm like, okay, this. If I'm doing daily streams, I'm, you know,
Shell
yeah, I'm gonna run out.
Petrol contains detergents that clean your engine as you drive.
No telly
first,
stuff apart from that. Yeah, it really was just the play out thing, and I was quite a minor part of the play out sort of thing. You know, I was the metadata, the TV listings guy, essentially, the schedules. So when stuff overran,
what the
things like
us?
That. Or
this week
I was just up there
predict
actually
your
changing.
Future for the next 6 months, your love life, work and travel prospects, a complete 16-page guide to your future.
This is far scarier than anything in the Amityville Horror.
Thank you.
Justin Toper predicts your 6 month stars only in the sun.
When the heat is on and the pace is slow, there's a cool fresh world where you can go.
I like how it's labeled like social distancing and science without ice cream. I used to just call it because I hate people. Yeah. I mean, effectively, I have been social distancing for quite a long time. Pretty much since September, you know.
Get your holiday off to a flying start this year. Cruise across to the continent
awkward.
With P&O European ferries. That way, the holiday starts as soon as you drive aboard.
Look at the sky next door.
Especially
today.
If you choose the added luxury of our exclusive club class lounge.
All right. So, do you still
there
work?
There, you can
do
sit
you,
back in comfort and relax.
Do you still work for
so
Sky, or are you at Ericsson?
And refreshed.
Well, Red Bee Media.
P&O
oh,
European
Ericsson.
Ferries. Turn every crossing into a cruise.
Because yeah, I mean, I was working for Red Bee, as part of the metadata outfit, which I think is yeah, it's kind of lumped in now with the subtitling and signing things. Yeah, I saw the BBC announcers on a daily basis when I was in Playout, Katie. Some of them are really nice people. A couple of them are cunts. Sorry. A couple of them are bad people. I really, you know, even if I can't make the stream friendly, I need to try and be aware that people might have kids in the room. You work for Deluxe in Media City. Oh, okay. No, I'm all of the BBC stuff is still, yeah, based down in White City. You'd love to come stand near there outside. I don't think. Did you? What, outside the broadcast centre? Because, yeah, well, I mean, Playout hasn't been at Television Centre for quite a long time. I love the odd swear, so unexpected, yeah. So, yeah, I've never actually seen were you there for a particular reason, Katie? I mean, that's a bit weird if you were just turning up to sit in reception. Yeah, I've never actually seen the broom cupboard. Obviously, I've seen the continuity booth now. Oh, so exciting stuff here. Hello, Paul. You were there once for an interview. Just a locked off. Yeah, I mean, as I say, I've seen what the continuity booths now are, and I don't imagine they're smaller than they used to be. So, yeah. Right. Got through that one quickly. Yeah. Funny that. Although you say that, I've been streaming for nearly 40 minutes. Patton,
who is not in the cabinet yet. Though he might be come tomorrow, but at transport, if Paul Channon leaves and he takes over there. As for the party chairman's job, which Peter Brook is certain to leave, the hot favourite for that is Kenneth Baker, at present at education.
Played RTD2,
one of Mrs.
Course.
Thatcher's earliest decisions was that involving Lord Young, agreed at a meeting earlier this month. As he began his weekend, he was still turning aside the inevitable reshuffle questions with the inevitable answers.
It's fine. What most about of them are dead or retired.
You're going to return to industry. Well, we shall have to wait. The Prime Minister's the one who announces all the changes.
Mr. Baker began his weekend in relaxed mood. Many Tory MPs will see his becoming chairman as another step towards his succeeding Mrs. Thatcher eventually, especially if he helps her win the next election.
No, those MPs will also welcome
Chris
centre.
Patton's promotion to the cabinet.
Katie.
In fact, he was already
different.
Celebrating last night.
Yeah,
no,
Broadcast
he hadn't
Centre
had an early
is in
phone
White
call.
City.
It was only in honour of his recent
centre.
Elevation to the Privy Council.
But why do we have to have a reshuffle at all with all the phone calls and all the comings and goings through these gates here tomorrow up to the front door of number 10? Well, Mrs. Thatcher says it's about bringing on young talent. But this time, she's also got to do something
none of the
to
people
sharpen
she
up
just,
her team's performance.
They just showed
policies
were young.
Like water privatisation
not
and
a
the poll tax,
one of them.
Where things are going rather badly for the government at the moment. Michael Branson, ITN, Downing Street.
A disabled pensioner and his elderly wife have been stabbed to death at their home in New Haven in Sussex. Police, who've described the murders as horrific, say that Stephen and Iris Hadler may have disturbed a burglar.
Police were called to the semi-detached house close to New Haven Harbour after
this
neighbours
really
became suspicious.
Video.
Officers who forced their way in discovered the bodies of Stephen Hadler and his wife Iris, both in their 70s, lying upstairs. They'd been stabbed
repeatedly.
Oh, I
know, but you can't say
obviously,
young talent when none of them
who is a very
when they're all over 40,
person,
you know.
A very dangerous individual, so this is not the type of offence that a person can protect somebody from. And if somebody does suspect somebody in their own house or the person next door, then I urgently appeal for them to come forward.
Detectives believe the pensioners who've lived here for 25 years disturbed an intruder. Neighbours are still shocked at the loss of close friends.
Absolutely incomprehensible. Absolutely.
And your feelings towards the person responsible?
This is a really cack-handed news report. I'm sorry, I know people have died, but...
An incident room has now been set up at nearby Eastbourne Police Station, and detectives have appealed for anyone who was in this area on Friday night or early Saturday morning, or who may have seen or heard anything suspicious, to contact them as soon as possible. Robert Hall, ATN, New Haven.
Within the last hour, the BBC and union negotiators have reached a deal on pay, which should end their three-month-old dispute. They've agreed to an across-the-board increase of 8.8%. The unions had wanted 16. Members will now be balloted on the offer. The directors of Britain's biggest bank, the National Westminster, are holding an emergency meeting tonight over the scandal involving its city offshoot, County NatWest. MPs have demanded resignations following an official report accusing County NatWest of misleading the stock market during a city takeover battle.
It's most unusual to see any activity in the city on a hot July Sunday, let alone photographers outside the NatWest Bank.
British cousin of
Board members were called for an emergency meeting in the wake of a government inspector's report, which has some of the most damning criticisms ever made of a British bank. Careers are on the line. The conduct of John Plastow and two other directors is said by the inspectors to have fallen below that to be expected of senior executives of NatWest. Chairman Lord Boardman escaped direct criticism in the report. He's now under pressure to purge top management and himself retire early. He's due to be succeeded by the leading lawyer, Lord Alexander.
Will anyone be resigning?
I think you better wait till after the meeting. The board has to consider the position fully.
County NatWest, the bank's stockbroking subsidiary, misled the stock market over the amount of shares it owned in the employment group Blue Arrow after the takeover of an American company, Manpower. County feared if the market realised how many Blue Arrow shares it held, the price would plunge. In the end, County NatWest lost £65 million anyway. The Bank of England and other city regulators now have the power to demand that heads roll.
The directors of NatWest know that whatever action they take, the matter is far from resolved. The Serious Fraud Office and the City of London Police are investigating possible criminal aspects of the affair. Hugh Pym, ITN, The City.
Japan's ruling centre-right party has suffered its worst ever election defeat in voting for the parliamentary upper house. The Prime Minister, Sosuke Uno, who's at the centre of a sex scandal, may now be forced to call an early general election.
With a Churchillian gesture, Takako Doi, Japan's socialist leader, claimed victory after her party sent back more than twice as many candidates to the upper house of parliament. With most of the votes counted, the ruling Liberal Democrats have lost badly. For the first time since the party was formed in the 50s, they've lost their majority in the upper house. As Ms. Doi posted each new socialist success, she became more confident her party can go on to win power in a general election.
I will try with all my might to be a ruling party.
There was a different mood at LDP headquarters. For 34 years they've been in office. Simply losing the upper house won't change that. But if these results were repeated at a general election, Japan would cease to be a one-party democracy.
Random old news bulletin.
Such a major economic and industrial country like Japan,
and I'm not having had no change of government for more than 30 years,
is an aberration. No other countries in the world, no other mature democracies in the world have had this kind of experience.
And boring, yeah. you're right,
the first casualty is likely to be the Prime Minister, Sosuke Uno. His affair with a geisha girl destroyed his party's support among women voters. Now even some of his senior colleagues want him to resign.
But the question remains whether this is simply a protest vote, or whether, for the first time in more than 30 years, the Japanese people really do want a change of government. James Mates, ITN, Tokyo.
Now with news of the closest Open Championship for 14 years and the rest of the day's sport, here's Mark Austin at Royal Troon.
After a day of high excitement here at Royal Troon, Mark Calcavecchia is the new Open Champion.
Well, yeah, it's interesting that looking back, Greg Norman, Wayne Grady,
win his first major title. And it took a playoff to do it, the first time that happened in the Open for 14 years. The Australian Wayne Grady had led for two days, and came the ultimate test. Would he buckle under the pressure? And that pressure came from Greg Norman.
So yeah, she's
Grady's
now Lady McGregor.
Grady's countryman played one of the great rounds of Open golf. He
Lord
began
Lieutenant
with six successive birdies. The Australian flag was flying high, so too was Norman. He started seven shots adrift. He finished one stroke off the lead. But behind him, Wayne Grady showed no sign of cracking.
I always enjoyed Wayne Grady.
He held the lead until the penultimate hole, when this miss sent the Open to a playoff.
Yeah, I know Mark Austin's still around.
The other contender, Calcavecchia, a round of 68 gave him the chance for his first major.
The dramatic playoff was over four holes.
You've subtitled him enough times to know.
But Calcavecchia birdied the second, and the Open headed for a last hole showdown. On the 18th, Norman's extraordinary surge met a disappointing end. He struggled in the sand, while Calcavecchia hit the shot that won the Open.
Stand still, please. Ready.
I was just thinking that he looked very sinister.
For the
third time,
Greg Norman had lost a major in a playoff. This time to an American who's never won one.
Well, that means
great
everyone.
Hey,
Richard,
how are you?
You know, I haven't fully realised the meaning of this, but it'll set in, and you know, this thing's not leaving my arms.
The victory salute was British.
I'm assuming that was
for the first time
was
in 6 years. The Open Trophy belonged to America. An American victory too in the
Tour
de France.
Which is not a question you have to
Greg LeMond won it in one of the closest ever.
I'm always very happy to. You know, I ask it because
Le Monde overturned the 50-second advantage held by
that,
the Frenchman Laurent Fignon in today's final stage to win by just 8 seconds.
It's kind of my default.
It was a remarkable comeback for Le Monde, who almost quit
it is
cycling
always a genuine
after being
question.
Injured in a shooting accident 2 years ago. British Lions have rounded off their victorious tour of Australia with a 19-15 win over a combined Australia New Zealand
side. Yeah, having kind of worked in the same bit, it's a mix.
The only try of a scrappy first half was the Lions. Brendan Mullin breaking through some weak tackling in the centre. Gavin Hastings was there to give
Actually,
it back to the Irishman to make it 6-all.
Certainly a red B.
In the second half, the Anzacs went back into the lead when David Campese, the villain of last week's test, kicked cleverly out
so
of defence.
So the software
Ian
is
Williams
trained
to
do the
Hastings
horse.
Brothers, and nobody was going to catch him.
And you're then speaking
a few minutes later,
you're hearing.
Griffiths was lucky the referee
didn't repeating
see him
it
head-butting
so that it's
Farr Jones.
As close to being accurate as possible.
But the Lions' second try was a real classic. The Hastings brothers this time keeping their feet
know,
in the tackle
SPW,
to make it available for Devereux.
Like if you see a mistake, do you correct those as it goes along?
The embattled
as well?
Lions lost Young, Mullin, and Evans to nasty looking injuries.
Hey,
but showing great
How
spirit sealed the match with drop goals first from the baby of the team, Chalmers. And then to climax a superb tour from Gavin Hastings. Giles Smith, ITN Sport.
No worries, man.
Tim Robinson.
I just thought of that in the, you know, in the moment.
Old Trafford on Thursday.
The four of us were on.
Robinson's been brought in along with the Northamptonshire spinner, Nick Cook. Robin Smith and Neil Foster, who didn't play in the last test because of injury, are also back. Kim Barnett, Chris Tavares and Paul Jarvis are the casualties from the last test, which ended in a draw.
Well, they're not
Finally, the Duke
are
and Duchess of York have been giving away some of the secrets of their small talk during walkabouts
on
their visit
yes.
to Canada. In a special ITN interview with Ken Rees, they explained why they liked being on tour.
But what is very special is being able to go out and meet as many people as possible. That's the real point.
I think the fun bit is for the job we do. I think the best
or at least accused
is
of
going out and talking to the people.
Slightly daunting.
Potentially
cancelled. You're not used to it, and you haven't done it
pizza time.
For a long time.
Is he sweating?
It's wonderful meeting people. And
there's always something funny you can say. Gosh, that did you take long to do your hair? And you look very pretty today. And why are you wearing a sailor suit? Is that because your father's in the Navy?
Some
I mean,
Pizza
I
Express,
find that you just managed to go from one thing to the next. But I think we're both quite good at speaking, and we do talk a lot, don't we?
And one of the things Canadian crowds wanted to know was how was Princess Beatrice?
Well, she's great.
Keeping in touch on the telephone as best we can.
We heard 2 days ago that she'd taken her first 5 steps on her own. So it's been a very special tour in a way because we've heard that she's now walking.
And that's it for now. ITN has news bulletins on ITV throughout the night. But from all of us here on the weekend team, have a very good evening.
Bye. Wow.
Good.
Good evening. Another uncomfortable night ahead, I'm afraid. It's going to stay this way as well for the next couple of days.
If you can join me
for either of the two earlier forecasts tomorrow, we'll be having a look at the whole of the week ahead, so perhaps there'll be some change towards the end of the week. But no changes tonight. Staying dry for most of us. The odd thundery shower in the southeast, soon dying out. Temperatures well up everywhere overnight. Another sticky one, I'm afraid. Tomorrow, lots of sunshine again across the whole of the UK, really. Lots of sunshine, the best of it down in the southwest. Only the west of Scotland, I think, missing out during the afternoon in particular.
Good question.
And there could be the odd spot of drizzle over the Western Isles and some patchy fog again over in the northeast there. Temperatures tomorrow, just like those of today, and with hardly a breath of wind, it really is going to feel very hot indeed. 31,
sticky
for instance,
one.
That's 88. So another hot one everywhere. Hope for some change later in the week if you don't like
February,
it. I'll leave you with
a
summary of tomorrow's weather.
Martin Davis. I'm getting too good at this now. By which I mean I got one right, and that probably is too good.
Good evening.
Really.
The weather now for the LWT area. Another extremely hot and humid day behind us, and the night is not going to offer any improvement. It'll remain humid and very warm. By the end of the night, it'll become misty with patchy low cloud. The minimum temperatures will be around 18 degrees Celsius, 64 Fahrenheit. Most of the region should stay dry, though there's just the slimmest chance of a thundery shower in the east. The winds will be very light, so another uncomfortable night with not much sleep to be had. Monday morning, any mist and low cloud will quickly disperse to give a dry day with sunshine. The temperatures will rise rapidly to give us a maximum afternoon temperature of 30 degrees Celsius, 86 Fahrenheit. It'll feel very hot and humid. The winds will be light northwest to northeasterly. The outlook is for more dry, sunny, hot weather, hopefully becoming less humid. That's all from us this weekend. Good night.
I mean, that studio is clearly...
Can the perfect marriage be improved?
Like
they'll have to be quick. The last, that's love. Next.
Wow.
Chessington, world of adventures.
Nice.
You know how the British are terribly reticent, hate boasting? Well, that's rubbish. When you buy a new Metro or Maestro Clubman, shove it down people's throats. Look, I've got a new Clubman, and you, haven't they? And I've got a free sunroof, and I've got a free stereo, and I've got a free wee badge. Pity it's not a big badge, really. But the best bit, and this'll really get in their wick, when you park outside the house, leave the price ticket still on it.
Wow.
By now, you'll have seen these new
stamps on
the long
Billy
mail, celebrating Britain's magnificent industrial heritage. But here's something different. The stamps are now additionally presented in special new designs and linked in this beautiful miniature sheet. It costs £1.40 at your post office from July the 25th onwards. If you want this miniature sheet or any future special stamps posted direct to your home, phone 0800 444 222 now for full details.
Just an advert for stamps.
Psst,
why not?
Ever, it's on Capital Gold. Listen to Kenny Everett and great music on Capital Gold. Only the lonely. On 1548 AM, classic hits all day, every day. You're just
too good. Ah, that's to nice, though, if you met Billy Connolly and was a delight.
Turn on Capital Gold Radio tomorrow, the all-time great music station.
Klaus Thaler. Could anyone but the Germans brew it?
Some cars could convert to unleaded. Others can't. For those that could convert, but haven't, Esso introduces an alternative high-octane grade. New Super Plus unleaded. High performance, no engine adjustment, and no fuss.
I honestly think this may be my favourite tape of adverts so far. Everyone just feels like a classic. But not the kind of classics
these people
that
suffer from
I
the
know,
pain of
but
sensitivity.
Classics.
Hot things
like,
hurt.
They feel like
old
forgotten
things
classics.
Really hurt. Relieve sensitivity with Sensodyne
forgotten
toothpastes. Used every day, Sensodyne's special ingredients progressively relieve pain. And Sensodyne F has fluoride and a great fresh taste. Ask your dentist about sensitivity and use Sensodyne. Sensodyne toothpastes
we'll
to relieve the pain of sensitive teeth.
I think we powered our cars with that stuff. Yeah, hopefully.
Looks interesting.
It's a Californian wine.
Oh, yes.
A blend of Chenin Blanc and French Colombard grapes.
A Pauliate.
That's nice.
From Paul Masson's Monterey Vineyards.
Absolutely.
And 99.5% alcohol-free.
Masson Light. Wine with everything but alcohol.
Yeah.
Share in our special celebrations, Thames 21.
You've got some of the best killers in the world out there.
Ha! Join me for an outstanding collection of crime classics to celebrate 21 years of Thames Television's popular drama. From spy and private investigator to rebel and flamboyant trickster, they're the Thames Mavericks.
Dennis Waterman presents Callum, the first in the season, starting tomorrow at 9.
Okay, so this will be the summer of 1989 then. Suddenly wonder what it's all about. That's love. What? That's love. That's love. Just when you think you're on solid ground. Just a word and you're upside down. That's love.
Absolutely awful film. Hmm? Awful. You know, it's so bad I can't even concentrate on this. I keep thinking about it.
Perhaps it wasn't so bad then.
Well, how do you make that out?
Well, it obviously left an impression.
Well, of course it left an impression. I didn't say it was insipid, I said it was awful. I'm full of bloody impressions. Can't get rid of them. Like wallpaper on the eyeballs.
Interesting.
What's interesting about it? I wish I could go into the bathroom and wash my mind out.
Series.
No wonder the cinemas are closing down all the place.
They're not, they're open.
Production company Lawson Group.
They were closing last year. TV. You're out of date as usual.
£5.40 it cost too. £5.40 I paid to be bored stupid.
You didn't, I paid.
What?
You only had 40p on you, I paid the £5.
Right, that is big
well,
hair.
Me? What's the difference?
Saccharine.
£5. But I don't mind, I like the film. So, I'll stand you that. You've only lost 40p, feel better?
You like it. I knew it.
You guessed, did you, when I wouldn't leave with you in the middle of the
climax. I mean, this isn't a rainbow
climax. Is that what it was? Oh, come on, Patsy, how could you like it? Sentimental rubbish.
Sorry.
It was awful.
So you said.
All that Earth Mother stuff, that ugly old rat bag dropping her offspring all over Africa, and then breastfeeding them with one hand while she was defending her boring big game park from poachers with the other. Nothing to ecology a bad name.
You can't breastfeed with one hand.
Well, one breast then.
And you certainly can't defend a game park with the other breast.
What?
Good with hers.
The image breaks down.
Oh dear, sorry, the image breaks down. Getting a bit purist, aren't we, this evening?
It's just that I don't like to see something as sincere and rich and full of life as that film was attacked for arid, non-thought-through, anti-rightness reasons.
No couple has ever had a conversation.
Where did you get
like
that one
this?
From?
That film was wonderful. It was
not
an anthem
even in 1989.
To celebrates the life force at work in all of us.
I should say it did. Every time we got a close-up of some
even
animal,
ITV
the creature gave
this,
birth.
They re-showed the piglet.
Even when we thought it was a male. She called them all babies.
This
mad
whole,
babies,
this whole comedy
she called
seems
them.
To be
but
I'm
that's
a grumpy
what they
husband.
Were to her.
She was a litter as well as incontinent. Look, when a lion has young, they're cubs,
you had this
not
conversation
baby
last
lions.
Night, did you, Chris?
Words an elephant word. Has a calf, not, a baby elephant. We do have words in the language for these sort of things, you know, if we're getting all purist about it.
All right, then, Noel, what should she have called those two baby warthogs?
Frankenstein and Quasimodo, I should have thought. Baby warthogs, that goes too far. Horrible-looking little monsters.
Oh, they were sweet.
sweet and sour, that might be acceptable.
I don't know what's the matter with you. I really don't.
It's just because I didn't go gaga at the sight of that woman and her menagerie firing offspring out all over the place like champagne corks.
It was a story of nature versus greed, of life, real life, versus so-called civilization. Of woman the creator versus man the destroyer. Yes, I know it's corny. But it was beautiful, it was relevant and...
Also, why is she so badly lit?
What's that?
Pills.
What pills?
What pills do you think?
You mean...
Brilliant. So are these. And that. And these. And this.
Oh, what pills?
Artificial lot of them.
The studio audiences are laughing. Are they there. Watching something else?
It's amazing how much useless junk you can accumulate over the years, isn't it?
To be fair,
on the time of
the studio recordings, I've always found that...
You're having that coil fitted after all,
are you? Kind of scratches in the atmosphere.
No.
I went to four of the six recordings for Red Dwarf 10.
Am I to understand?
Hole in one, OB.
I'll be honest,
We've been seeing a film about Broody Wildlife, and you've got Broody.
I mean, I can't speak for this particular sitcom. It was very rarely canned laugh. It's very rarely canned laugh.
Softening up. I was daft enough to think you'd enjoy it. And then I'd have used it as a starting point for a discussion about whether or not we should have another man cub. So, shall we?
This is like toothache. You know you shouldn't touch it, but you can't help yourself. I can't not watch this. This is how I'm feeling.
Well, we've got two already, haven't
we? Because it's a sitcom that...
Well, it's not me personally. I'm just
thinking I've never heard of, and it's not available on DVD. I'm like...
I mean, if we have another civilised one over here, they have to chop a rainforest down over there.
Oh, sod the rainforest! I've gone all broody.
Well, what's brought this on?
I don't know. Mother Nature, I suppose. I'm a woman, you know.
I have noticed, yeah.
Yep, no, none of us remember it, Katie.
It's coming from Olive's room. There's something banging on the wall.
Oh, no.
There's never a person
in this. I told her that would happen. She wanted to move the furniture around and put her bed against this wall. Said it looked nicer there.
It must have shifted a bit. She's not having a nightmare, is she?
I remember
no,
it vaguely.
She's got a boyfriend with her tonight. She'll be so embarrassed when I tell her.
Oh, she's shagging.
Well, we can't have that every time he stays. She'll have to move it back in the morning.
Oh, it's quite entertaining. He's very impressive, isn't he? Bang, back.
No, don't. She'll be mortified.
The two actors are Jimmy Mulgirl and Diana Hardcastle.
Come on.
Lisa Goddard and Tony Slattery. Ah. Lisa Goddard was in Series 3 and Tony Slattery was in Series 4.
So you're giving up the pill just like that, are you?
Well, at least I've asked you about it first.
Told me, you mean?
No,
this would be
I
one of the first
if you
two series, though, because
I could have kept quiet and just let things
and also because
happen,
it ran
but I think
from
that's
88
a rotten
trick.
Yes.
So now you know.
Well, as I haven't agreed, couldn't you keep on taking it until I do?
That'll be never.
Well...
I can't force you to make me pregnant, but you can't force me to take the pill either. That's fair.
Gosh.
Yes, it is. So we'll just have to let nature take its course. After all, we don't have to make love.
Oh, blackmail.
No. I mean, after all, I'm depriving myself too if you decide not to.
So what she's saying is that if you don't shag her, she's going to whack you off into a cup while you're asleep and then...
You could try.
Let's just cut through the bullshit.
Taking the pill.
Just now.
Oh, so.
I could get pregnant any time.
So is that how that works?
Good night.
She must be 15 years old. I don't think she is. It's hard to tell with both of her hair. There's a dog. Hello. Finally.
Hello, Olive.
Thought you'd gone to bed hours ago.
Couldn't sleep.
No couples like sex in sitcom.
Rotten, isn't it?
To be honest, Claire, I suspect this wasn't great at the time.
Glad to hear it.
I came down for a glass of water.
Thirsty work?
Enjoy
it. He's thirsty.
Oh, well, yes. Does he always drink his water from a saucer? Dominic.
Yeah. Hey? Oh, I'm daft. I don't know what I'm doing.
And of course, well, the crazy thing is that...
Oh, hello.
This is Olive, one of the other recurring characters. The sitcom is now already, by percentage, more
one
diverse than Friends.
Yeah, I was just dashing up and down between the two of them.
Or Frasier. Or
well,
Cheers.
Good night. I've got to see the other one now.
A bit awkward, this.
Dominic wanted a glass of water.
He takes milk with it, does he?
Well, he couldn't make up his mind.
Yeah, so this is Olive, played by Vivian McCone.
What's the matter with her?
Post-coital confusion, I think.
Lucky her.
Yeah. I've met this chap of hers. What's he like?
He's nice. Well, he's gorgeous. Crazy about her.
Yeah, I wasn't 100% sure, Tom, when it started, whether
we're
gonna it was
definitely
a sitcom.
We're going to get very tired drinking tea every night if we don't sort something out soon.
Yeah, visually it does look quite like a soap.
Dominic brought me this present, you see, for our 10th anniversary. It's 10 weeks since we met.
Oh, Ken! This is suddenly much better.
Oh, isn't he adorable? Oh, look, Donald, just look.
Don't be a knob, Donald.
Oh, of course you can. The children will love it. Oh, he's lovely. Oh, Donald, look, a baby kitten.
A baby kitten?
Knew it was worth hanging around for.
Heard of a baby kitten? It's a kitten, a young cat. Look, a kitten is a blinking baby already. You're having baby babies next.
Don't be so pedantic, you old grouch.
Broodiness has made your brain go squashy.
What is it, Olive, a boy or a girl?
Boy.
Ah.
Calm down.
Isn't he a beautiful boy, aren't you? A little beautiful.
Look, they're toms and queens, males and females. Boys and girls are human beings, remember?
Because that's
two legs, not much
premise
fur, power
of reason,
theoretically.
On EDIYT.
You're frightening him.
But it terrifies me.
It's not an it, it's a him.
EDIYT.
It will be an it. If...
It's me going through old videos. Nelson, I've bought on eBay.
Come on, Nelson. Kill, Nelson! Kill!
Jimmy Mulvalone.
He loves him, really. He's just showing off.
Okay. You're not having any puppies, are you, Nelson? No? Not even baby puppies? No. Oh, I forgot you're a fella like me, aren't you? Join the club. Did I say club?
No, not at all, Tom.
Don't know yet, but he has a pedigree, so something grand, I think.
Yeah. Suppose the kids are allergic to cats.
I thought of that. They're almost certainly not.
How do you know?
Yeah, now.
Well, they breastfed, weren't they, Patsy?
Yeah.
Breastfed children rarely have allergies, and they're packed with goodies, antibodies from their mummy's milk.
Mummy's milk, I give it.
All children should be breastfed. It's the best food there is for babies, and not enough mothers do it.
While fighting off big game poachers with the other one.
Ignore him.
This is going to end with him killing the cat.
Did I hear him say broody just now?
Who's he? The cat's father?
Probably.
It seems like the only natural escalation.
No.
He's just going to, you know.
Sorry.
Yeah.
We're thinking about it, but Donald won't.
Brutally murder the cat.
Don't look at me like that.
And the credits will roll in.
Go on, you've got everything here. You wouldn't even notice another one. Patsy can still do her designing, and I'll do all the extra messy bits.
It's a female conspiracy.
Not just females. Dominic
the cute dot there looks like a pause.
I thought you were taking rather more practical steps.
Arguably, it's not even started.
Don't worry, honestly, pay no attention. Donald!
Anyway, we've decided, not yet, he's got to do his degree, then his medical finals. So you're safe, I won't leave you in the lurch.
There's no lurch to be left in.
Oh, thanks, Olive, you're lovely.
Mind you, I think three's a bad number. Odd numbers, two always gang up on one.
There, see?
You must have four. Like Gary and Amanda.
So. I just want to pause there. So, what's actually happened in the first 15 minutes of this sitcom? The grumpy couple have sat in bed and not had sex, and then they've come downstairs and their lodger, I guess, is there, and There's a kitten. And that's it. Like, I know sitcoms could be slow, and that not every sitcom would necessarily have an involved plot, but this feels like it's being stretched really thin, mate. Sitting in bed not having sex is a theme in most of these sitcoms. Yeah, that's true, but... Well, okay, there we go. Let's crack on with the ads. It's a theme in my life, too.
Mind you, I think 3's a bad number. Odd numbers, 2 always bang on.
I don't know what she was banging on about with that.
You must have 4. Like Gary and Amanda. Huh.
What fascinated me too is that she's still badly lit. Yeah, you're right. I think it's the hairspray making her too matte. Here we go.
Time to stop. Make it McDonald's to go.
A visit to McDonald's makes your day.
You actually can go to a MacD's, you just can't sit down in a MacD's. Yeah, drive-through can, and I'm assuming that you can go in and order takeaway. McDonald's always did it. McDonald's was a treat then, now it's a staple.
My
yeah.
company has developed a low-cost solar pump.
I know.
Is anybody interested?
What language should this man use to talk to overseas customers?
Is anybody there?
English.
Voulez-vous un pompe solaire?
It isn't French.
Eine Sonnenpumpe Gerät.
It isn't German. Maybe he should try a different language altogether.
Come on, guys, just speak English but louder. That's what we do.
For this is the business language of the future. And thanks to British Telecom's
the only
network,
beer left
you can speak
it
anywhere in the world.
Is that actually true?
It can help overseas buyers picture your product instantly. It will even tempt new prospects to phone you free using our international 0800 numbers.
I think we're in business, Derek.
On a kind of gut level, I actually get it.
Maybe you should
start
talking
now. Because I don't think people are actually
pack,
of the influence
free on 0800 800 828. British Telecom. It's you we answer to.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, but there's just a mental connection between Corona and coronavirus, isn't there? Just on a gut level, you're like, I don't fancy drinking that, because it's, yeah. I mean, I certainly don't drink beer. If I did drink it, it'd be, you know, fine. It's 1989, Tom.
In here, we can dodge them all for a minute. I want to talk to you.
Oh, golly, what about?
I think that's terrific news.
What?
You're going to have another one?
Hurry on its own.
I'm not.
No.
Anyway,
enough.
What made you think I was?
I'm not sure I'm able to say that word,
too. I don't think I'm nosy, but I found out by accident.
How?
I mean, I'm sure
well,
I am.
Olive had my 4
I mean.
Over at your place yesterday while I went up to the West End.
Yeah. I missed the old TMA.
I went to fetch them.
Yeah.
And I had to use your loo. So Olive sent me up to your room.
Yes.
Well, I love looking around other people's houses and things, don't you?
Well,
so what I'm trying to say is I found your dildo drawer.
It was full of birth control devices.
Oh,
you didn't
I
take
mean,
any
not
chances,
far off.
Did you?
I'm just having a clear out.
Lucky bear.
I know these gestures only mean one thing.
Well, anyway, Donald won't, so that's that.
Husbands are the least of the problem when it comes to getting so pregnant.
I guess it must be March 1980, because, I mean, the temperatures
I mean,
were really high.
Gary didn't always like breeding, you know?
I assumed it was, Toad.
Is this compliant, submissive little Amanda I can hear talking?
Well, we'll just have to change Donald's mind for him, won't we? He'll never notice.
Yeah, I know you well enough. You know, you can't reason with him. Well, but I know you well enough to know that.
He'll think it was his idea eventually.
Oh,
I don't know. Donald isn't like Gary. I mean,
a man called Donald in 1990.
No, I've always been very direct with Donald.
Yeah, the shoulder pads. I mean,
never mind. Now, Gary's the best one to start on him. Gary loves children.
So does Donald.
No, I mean really loves them in hordes.
Are you really sure that Gary's the right person?
Oh, Gary can be amazing when he likes. Really subtle.
Man, you looked majestic last time, like a galleon in full sail.
That's what I mean.
Well, don't you like galleons?
I get seasick easily.
What about the actual birth? I mean, that is fantastic. I was there for all four of mine.
Oh, please.
Oh, weren't you?
So I guess
was there for the first half hour of the first one. I was sweating, frightened. Patsy yelled extra hard, and I was sick over the midwife. I stayed away from the next one by request of the midwife.
I took videos of all mine being born. Here, I'll bring them around, shall you?
Yeah. We'll make an evening of it.
Yeah!
Because, yeah, Gary was played by Neil Pearson from Series 2 to 4. Yeah. And that's not him.
Mm. Oh, sorry, forgot. You're off sex, aren't you?
Only with my wife.
Well, look, if she's willing to go through with it and have another kid, then why not?
She's mad.
You're not getting it delivered.
You can't trust women, not about these things. Nature turns their brains soft, doesn't it? They forget. All they remember are the little fingers and the baby blue eyes looking up and saying coochie cool and gurgles and all that stuff. They forget. They forget all the pain. They forget all the...
Yeah, it is a bit, isn't it?
I always hoped that would get better as I got older.
Does it?
No.
So what about bringing another little Donald into the world?
I do tell.
What about the cost?
Oh, peanuts. It's a pittance to pay for your own immortality. You should have two more at least. And then they'd have several each, and then you could be the founder of a dynasty, a family tree.
You sound like an acorn.
You see little grandchildren looking like you. The Abraham of the next century. You could father a nation.
You talk it fluently, don't you?
What?
Gibberish.
But if I'm willing to...
Are there
going to
be any jokes?
Surely that's all that matters, isn't it?
What?
Well, it's only a few months, and you could go away while I have it.
Oh, that's not fair.
You could have a holiday somewhere hot. Egypt. You've always wanted to see the pyramids. We could be away in the middle of winter if we timed it right.
No.
She wants him to impregnate her and then bugger off.
I don't want to go to Egypt.
Well, stay
yes,
here, Tom.
Yes, we are.
Oh. Mexico.
We're in 2D.
Before it gets spoiled.
Well, there you are. Terrific.
And we'll go together. And not while you're pregnant.
It's like not going out, but from the Tim Vine character's perspective. Yeah, okay, I can see that. Hey, there's the star of the show.
He's lovely, isn't he?
Mm. What are you going to call him?
I think Caesar.
You can't call that thing Caesar.
Twat.
Might as well call it Fang or Rambo.
That's what she's suggesting, Stan.
It's a sort of habit they have.
Don't you start.
Well, you have to stretch your imagination a bit.
Here. You try imagining a mangy 12-year-old mog still being fed on the table because it formed the habit whilst it was young.
Oh, okay, sorry. I was afraid Nelson would steal his milk.
Well, that dog would steal anything.
I don't know, maybe I'll get my bowl with Caesar on it.
I mean, the dog playing Nelson is just sat there.
Nelson's an avid reader.
I'm not having any part of this, guys.
You know, being a nanny makes me impervious to most forms of kiddywink sentimentality.
Oh, she's a nanny.
But if there's one thing that
I mean, we've not seen any kids in this at all.
When I see them sitting there like that and think of those four little feet.
So these guys apparently already have two kids.
It's no good.
Two invisible children, presumably due to child labour law.
And these things shouldn't be left on the table either.
There has been no domestic commercial release of the series on any format in the UK. Yeah.
Bloody wellies. Bloody women.
Bloody women.
Yes,
he's definitely going to come round eventually.
Oh, the children.
He's almost round already. The really endearing thing about him is that most of his reluctance is out of genuine concern
for me. It might be, Tom. I'm certainly going to upload the episode to...
Yes, probably that too. He's ready. But he is genuine. I mean, he really doesn't want to put me through it again.
Oh, men are so thoughtful.
Donald Bloody is men.
I wonder if he'd stop you making the sacrifice if you were giving birth to a brand new Ferrari. Blow the tea, let's have some wine.
Oh, wonderful. Anyway, the fact that I'm willing to put up with the labour pains and Olive's going to have the nappies seems to be persuading him.
What? Men don't know they're born, do they? Female emancipation.
Cheers.
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 This is about a woman trying to trap a man into being having a baby.
Yes. Do you know, I'd almost forgotten about that. I suppose men do have their uses. You know, I think I'll join you.
Not five. Why
How does
not?
This run we'll for do it four together series. This time.
Oh, that would be wonderful. Olive?
I'll pass on this one, thanks.
I must remember to leave off my wedding ring this time.
Whatever for?
Oh, I get the most terrible fat fingers. Blow up like anything.
Do you really?
Don't you?
No. My ankles.
I'm not sure that anybody's got to any point
like
here
balloons.
Yet.
And the backache I had with Zoe was hell.
Mine too. Still, at least that all goes.
It's more of a mood piece, that I in a way.
Once you've got those, you're stuck with them.
You can always have the op.
I've already got two.
Like a dull soap opera, but with fewer characters and cats. Yeah, I mean, good I said God, before that they've become very, very rare in these camps.
So far.
I'm beginning to wonder if this
you know, I've still
either that or they had a really good warm-up guy.
No.
You just put them up into
I'm
such a frenzy.
I'm stuck one side of my bra sometimes, picking myself up. When it's a very dressy occasion. Great. King size horror is the piles.
That took a turn.
They really get me down. Just when you're absolutely done in, you can't even sit down in comfort. I ask you, is it worth it?
One thing, might be right,
I won't let you forget to do your pelvic floor exercises.
I'm quite good about all that.
So I'm not.
Wait,
got
who
to be
looks
forced.
Just like her?
The last woman I was with before you, Patsy, never did them. And afterwards, for months, every time she sneezed or laughed, she peed herself.
We've got a few people against this switcheroo idea, by the way.
Well, for us, not for her.
I can sort of see what you mean, but...
Patsy. Sorry, you go.
May you.
Looks a little
well,
bit
Well, I've been thinking
like that, but...
about the baby. If that's what you...
Don't say another word. I understand.
Do you?
Yes, completely. We'll wait.
What?
Well, you're quite right. The world is very full.
Is it?
No.
Yes, and we do have two already.
Oh, well, yeah.
So it's shelved.
Okay.
Not forgotten, just shelved.
No, of course.
Yeah, that's very much
well,
my thinking, Dave.
It's midnight and the sun has just come out. Does this mean that, you know, is back on the agenda?
Why not?
Oh. Because the two of you are utterly what? Miserable and your hair might...
any pills.
Oh. Well, I've got nothing.
No, neither have I.
It's not. No, it's Jimmy Mulville. Stinky.
We could always ask Olive and Dominic.
No, leave them to it. We'll, think of something.
Gonna give him a blow. Gonna give him a blow. Wow. Different times.
Just when you think you're on solid ground, just a word and you're upside down. That's love.
Very much a pre-comedy era. That's correct, yeah. You're right, Tony.
That's love. That's love. That's love.
I don't think there was an end.
That's love. That's love.
smashing it at the same time, Tom.
All these familiar faces are part of a special weekend to celebrate LWT's 21st birthday. LWT 21, our coming of age marked with some of our best love programs. There's a royal gala and the LWT party. Join us next weekend.
To the feeling of community that we all sat through that together, you know?
Moving London's water around London will soon be much easier, because we're investing in a 50-mile pipeline that operates on the simplest of principles. Water runs downhill.
Well, I thought it was 89, because Thames started in 1968. That episode was from 1988, so 88 I would have been 4, and 89 I would have been 5. No, none of these have been taped by me at all. These are all tapes that I bought off eBay from randomers. So, yeah.
Lamont, seriously smooth.
No idea, but my tapes are long gone.
Share in our special celebrations, Thames 21.
You've got some of the best killers in the world out there. Ha.
Join me for an outstanding collection of crime classics.
Yeah, so that must have been a repeat 21 from years of Thames Television's the first popular series, drama. Then.
From spy and private investigator to rebel and flamboyant trickster. They're the Thames Mavericks.
Dennis Waterman presents Callum, the first in the season, starting tomorrow at 9.
Imagine they considered that good enough to repeat. Is that what this is? Right. Is this an intro into Horror? I don't think they did, Dave, no, because there was no break after the Amityville Horror. Tales of Sherwood Forest.
Treat you the way that I do, gee baby, and I'm good to you.
Yeah, no, I think this is a case where they just put it in.
For a girl that's so true.
Reminds me of Saturday afternoon drama.
Gee baby, and I'm good to you.
Yep, one long recording from beginning to end.
So. What you will for Christmas, a diamond ring.
Coco TV.
And everything. Love makes me treat you the way.
Oh, really, Gareth? Cameron Diaz sings this in the match.
Gee, baby, hey, I'm good to you.
People in this life, Fern, just don't care about the little people.
No, Mr. H.
But I care.
Yes, Mr. H.
I care about the little people. Except when they get in my way, then I hurt them.
Yes, Mr. H.
Oh, God, hateful apparatus.
23rd of July, 1989. No, he isn't. Brilliant.
Anything
Where'd
else?
Get that from?
Good.
Tubbs?
Is that Mr. Wilson?
Not unless he's had a sex change, no. And...
Everyone involved in this later.
Mr. Wilson?
Of course it goes all wobbly. You're not locking your thumb.
What?
Yeah.
What's that?
Hmm?
So what exactly is this then, Tobes?
One moment, Miss Asnett.
I'm off, Mr. Bowles.
What?
I'm sorry?
Off. If you won't be needing me.
No, no. Fine, of course.
Books to write, mountains to climb. Good news.
Playing golf in a bra, why wouldn't you do
deliver.
That?
Cheer-bye, then.
Cheer-bye.
Silly
I'm much just for release today. Sherwood Forest that came to Casablanca for the war.
Procedure, diplomacy, I must draft a letter. The law must be seen and not heard.
It's too late, he knows.
My God.
I told him. He was delighted. I wouldn't dream of saying.
Oh! Get out of the office, Jamie.
It's a comedy drama.
He's permanently tumescent.
Why? Because it's his property. He has a right to know, and now he has a right to confirmation. Rupert Hale will be disappointed. We can't help that, can we?
Disappointed? The man's a psychopath.
Tough titty.
Give me the document.
No. I feel like not enough people say tough titty anymore.
So pathetic.
If anyone dares say TV was better in my day, I can use this as evidence.
I have long harbored a morbid fear of being suspended from a meat hook. It would discompose me terribly.
The wages of cross-dressing and pervy golf.
Please!
Like an ice
out of my way!
Today.
So? You lost something, have you?
Hey? Oh, no. Just looking through a few old albums, actually. Suddenly got the urge to, you know. Don't worry, I'll clear up.
Eric, the owner of a nightclub in Nottingham, is obsessed by the film Casablanca.
Blimey, all right. Is that the time? Better.
Is anything the matter?
No. Why?
You've been in here hours.
Have I? Well, you're all right. Well, must have got carried away, I suppose.
So this is episode 7.
One thing leads to another.
The final episode.
Will you be late?
Shouldn't think so.
And you've got the key.
Yeah.
I was thinking.
Hmm?
That dream I dreamt the other night.
What about it?
Well, why? After all this time, why should I dream about my dad? I mean, he's been dead. Look, dead. How long is it?
I thought that was her from the last show.
I can't even picture his face, even.
Best tape yet.
So how is it? I wake up in the middle of the night, 40-odd years of age, calling for it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Well, that's probably just one of those things, I suppose.
I mean, I think when... I kind of hope we're near the end, won't I?
Suppose I better.
Although I also hope we're not. It's a tricky one. This is definitely SP. I've absolutely no idea what's going on, says Dave.
Oh, you came back then. What a night. You must be sodden. Anita, where's that
two sugars, was it? Made a drink for life then.
Did you get home all right, did you?
Probably an E180, but I didn't check before putting it in, so I don't know.
Well, I was wondering, you know, are you local? Or just passing through? Sorry, none of my business, is it?
All right, no worries, Toes. Thanks for coming along. Thanks for...
Scunthorpe.
Detective skills.
Scunthorpe?
Yeah.
Oh, really? I'm a superior mug.
Have a good one.
Scunthorpe.
Never said a word.
I could do
with
some telly addicts and
trick
contracts. That would be nice.
Do you know who I am? Sorry, I don't do requests.
Wow.
Over?
Great title. Give me a key.
G.
Quick slurp.
All I do is watch old stuff, yeah.
What's the use of getting sober when you gotta get drunk again? Oh, Sam done something fine when he broke that good whiskey.
I don't think so, Dave. No, I think
might
be. Good evening. Far to mark, I'm afraid.
Drink? Nah. Smoke? I'm in my sure.
Certainly not in the cafe.
So what's the use of getting sober?
Well, if there's anything you need. Sure. I'll just be here. All right.
Son, you ought to listen to your old pappy.
Yes, pappy.
And stop
drinking so much.
Oh, I ain't drinking so much, Pappy.
Shut up, boy.
I'll shut up now.
What's on the odd, Scott?
Gee, baby, ain't I good to you?
What?
Sing it now.
Em, is this in response? Chris, is this in response to a comment that I've missed?
Love makes me treat you the way that I do. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you?
Yes. Yeah, that's so good.
He worries me, Vilma.
Who?
The laughing policeman. Hope he's learnt his lines. If Hamilton walks out of court tomorrow with a new licence, I shall be seriously displeased.
Gross assault and battery on my person. Criminal indelicacy. And promiscuous irrigation.
Oh, right, Chris, yeah. What? It's all right. I wasn't sure
being
if it was a
smirching of the Motor Vehicle Act 1934. Whittling
yeah, I mean,
on the limo.
Isn't
that what besmirching means? Thank you very much, Fernan. Whittling. Sounds a bit bloody iffy to me, Bowles. That all we got?
You'd be quite surprised, then,
Scoopy!
But, yeah,
we're
probably.
Gonna nail his ass! Besmirching of motor vehicles? It's a rule!
Wait, better be.
Trust me already, I'm a lawyer! The law, I understand.
That's a
schmuck who owns my bar.
Any day, Whoopi. Real soon, I promise.
Tuxedo looks swell.
Hang in there, Bowles.
Yeah, I mean, I prefer not to watch stuff in the late 2000s, if I can put it.
Gee, baby, ain't I good to you?
Also, usually we don't watch that much stuff, but I don't know, they just felt a bit like chilling out, picking some of this stuff out. Plus, you know, none of it is on DVD, crucially.
I thought you were brilliant.
Yeah, 3 hours of BBC One from 2009. Yeah. I've even come across stuff as late as 2011-12.
Oh, just a minute.
Thanks. Thanks all the same.
What's on the Netflix history? I don't want to know. I mean, I'm at a weird point where, because I'm at my mum's, she's got the Virgin Media content filter on. By default, and I do not have the courage to broach that with her. So, my Netflix history tends to get a bit warped when I'm at my mum's. An advert from 2014 on the videotape.
Come on, man. We've cut your death out here.
I'm back! What the hell is that old coot doing in our bathroom?
I can explain.
I should hope you can.
You make me jump.
I'll make you jump, all right.
How was your evening, Mary?
Sod my...
What does that even mean?
Well, he's having a bath.
Yes.
Well, listen.
I am.
It was raining.
I know, I just walked home in it.
Oh.
Don't give me that. Get to the point.
Right. Where was...
There we go. I was just wondering whether this was actually going to be a 4-hour tape. First thing you'd... Yeah. Yeah, no, I agree, Hugian, but I've not signed up for it, so I don't have the password and things, and I don't have a legitimate reason to ask for the password. Stop recording. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I know that was an even slower hour of what's on the tapes than usual, but kind of wanted a bit of a slowdown. And it was interesting, I thought, anyway. So this one says M. Gaxon tape. And it also says Ocean's 12 on it, which is quite new, isn't it? When was Ocean's 12 released? Okay, so not that. Intrigued by the multiple gigabytes of disk space. I mean, it's actually not too bad. You know, I think it's come out as about a gigabyte an hour. And a lot of the time I'm not capturing the actual TV shows. You know, I'm capturing the adverts and things. It's only in cases like that where they're not available anywhere and you kind of go, okay, and let's face it, they're not available anywhere, and I'm kind of interested in the genre. Things like history documentaries, I've just not bothered. I know, but I don't care. So it'll end up being that, yeah. Right. So I don't know how much value we'll get out of this one, but let's pop it in and see. And that'll, again, well, this tape will probably be the last thing on the stream today. But it could still take quite a long time, just like that. I mean, that took a long time. Gaxon War. Time together watching it is the value we get out of it. Well, you know, I'm glad, you know. Right now, it feels like a fairly necessary thing to kind of have that getting together. That sitcom was crap, though. Oh, God, it's an LP tape. So that's like 6 hours of content. Not gonna lie, I might end up stopping around 3 o'clock and just going, okay, let's come back to this tomorrow. Because 2 hours tends to be when I start to get a bit antsy, a bit like, oh, maybe I could do something else now, or maybe I could do a drink and all this. Yeah. Let's see how we go anyway. No, we're not gonna watch the entire 6 hours. That was a loathe to say special occasion, but it was something a bit different. God, the 118. So yeah, we're definitely
118 childcare search sponsors ITV1 movies.
And everything about this is terrible so far. So I think this is Ocean's 12. Well, Ocean's 12 came out in 2004, so yeah, it's Ocean's 12.
Gail Diaz. Prepare to open a SEP retirement account.
Terrific.
Yeah, Ocean's 12, so we're probably talking retired. 2005, and 6 at the earliest.
I was a high school basketball coach.
Which is not something
done
that
very well for yourself.
I care about in terms of adverts and things, so let's... You know, I might go through it a late, you know, before I chuck the tape away or give it up, you know, whatever. I might go I'll probably still go through and get the ads at some point privately, but I'm not feeling it. After we've just watched a load of stuff from 1989, I don't fancy just mucking around in 2005. The whole film would be cut in about 17 minutes long. Yeah, no, I will, Dan. Don't worry. I'm getting fairly good at kind of gauging when to stop these things.
311-646.
Thank you.
This is still the Ocean film. I guess they've added in a lot of adverts. Nope, there we go. Oh, have we just leapt straight into something else?
Miss Smith.
2 hours, 21 minutes is quite... Well, I mean, it's... Not these days. That's about standard without an advert these days. I don't know what we've hopped into. And there's Judi Dench. Being Judi Dench. Judi Dench. Yeah, you're right. That's not even part one in a trilogy these days. Christ. Those little bonnets and sideburns. So that's the thing. I'll happily sit through half an hour of an old obscure sitcom. Because I'm interested in the medium, you know, I'm a big sitcom fan. I'm never going to sit through stuff like this, because, you know, even if the sitcom's bad, it's interesting to me. But, yeah, period dramas, I'm good. Bonnets and Sideburns is a good album title, yeah. I have copyrighted it though, so don't anyone be getting any ideas.
That,
what are we on now?
£365,000.
Okay, well, this is the first house we looked at, Sarah. Well, let's look at the wonderful carpet.
See you, Dan.
That was good though, with the floorboards.
Yeah, I like the floorboards.
You were talking to them.
Oh, the kitchen. That was a bit of a letdown.
And now in SP.
Very small, isn't it?
Yeah, it wouldn't work that way. Small bedrooms.
Well, is the first one with that.
That's far too small.
There's just no space at all.
Yeah, property number two.
Good, it's a house that you can walk into. It didn't need anything doing to it.
No, not at all. Yeah. I thought it was quite spacious as well.
I was just waving at the people on screen. Don't worry.
Bedroom was the first at the ensuite.
Probably got a good 10 minutes.
Surprise was to find some ensuite bathrooms.
Yeah. Oh,
into the main.
Obviously, what he uses is a master bedroom.
Yeah, even though it's slightly smaller.
That'd be an idiot.
That was stunning.
Really good.
Yeah, superb, the ensuite
bathroom. The house is all
dangerous.
Yeah,
it was a wild card,
wasn't
it?
Yeah, well, it was indeed.
Very well designed.
Yeah.
A nice sitting room, particularly with that feature fireplace.
That is.
That's fantastic. Gorgeous.
Don't get Dom, get
it's
somebody
to nice, present nice, a program. Bathroom there.
Yeah, I mean. He's not the most charismatic presenter. Oh,
some skirting boards. Now, you have got a concrete base in there, so it's not really serious. But what he recommends that you do is get a partial damp-proof course put in there and some adequate ventilation, and that should cure that.
Mm. Now, I didn't think I'd be saying this to you, but you do have a problem with your soil pipe.
Ouch.
Yes, the one on the front of the building over there. Now, if you look, it's actually quite close to the roof windows. Now, really, that soil pipe should be 3 feet above that window. Now, of course, that is going to look hideous, not very attractive at all. But the reason why you do that is because in summer, soil pipes have a tendency to smell. And I'm not talking about oriental lilies here. It's a bit whiffy. The only solution that really I can offer you is that you...
Make your own jokes about soil pipes here. This is already funnier than the sitcom.
Important question of the day. Are you going to barter for this cottage? Or are you going to scarper from his cottage?
I think we're barter or scarper? Hey,
fantastic.
It doesn't quite work, does it?
Well done. Even though it's your choice, you well, shake hands, can't be a gent. There you go. Well done.
Oh, well, all we can say now, the rumours, we hope it all works out. Yeah. Hope you're moving okay. Keep us informed.
Yeah. Really?
Thank you very much. I wish you all
thank
the
you
best.
Very much.
Lovely
thank
to meet you.
You.
Take thank care.
You.
Yes. Thank you both. What up? Oh, Chris, what a lovely ending to the
yep.
day. We show them three houses, they fall in love with one of them.
Yeah.
And they're going to buy it.
Dominic, I tell you, it's like a fairy story and everyone lives happily ever after.
Either is yeah. true. Yeah.
Now, if you out there would like us to come around and make your fairy tale come true,
then please don't hesitate and get in contact with Tweedledum pipe. And Tweedledee. And who knows, maybe next time we could be finding your magic kingdom.
You know what, then?
What's that?
No limo home, is it?
Oh, no, busting it. Dream's over.
Joker, yeah. You and I.
Price is correct in 2006.
We're turning into Keith and Susan. Oh,
my headphones got stuck.
Mine too. Now, Sue.
Oh. Outtakes. Blimey.
Now.
Pixar's got a lot to answer for.
Oh.
Her name is Sarah. I know it, Sarah. I know it inside out.
Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring.
What?
Merry Christmas, Red!
An ogre-tastic BBC One Christmas Shrek-tacular. Shrek the Halls, Christmas Eve at 6:35.
Doctor!
I'm the Doctor. I'm a Time Lord. I'm 903 years old, and I'm the man who's going to save your lives and all 6 billion people on the planet below.
Well, you look good for 903.
You should see me in the morning.
Okay.
I really like Boy.
Who's got their eye on 29 acres of pasture land? A slice of Somerset under the auctioneer's hammer in an hour. Well, is optional now on BBC One for a fresh start in the country.
Today I'm in a part of Britain that by many is, I think, quite overlooked, being as it is tucked away on the east coast of England. But it's also famously home to Oliver Cromwell and was the takeoff point for the great Dam Busters raid.
Oh, good. Now, have they just recorded a double bill of to buy or not to buy an escape to the country? Probably. Guys, I know it's 2007, my friends. Nope, 2007, Chris. The year after you met your wife. Yeah. I would just move house, you idiot. You don't need to televise it. Yeah, spawn, Dave. The Whovian is me. I mean... Oh, this is dodgy. Nice cheerful end to the tape.
But first of all, that's very nice. You have a glass of champagne, bubbles, and
wait,
bubbles.
What?
I love this.
It's beautiful, isn't
love
it?
Love it.
For her and her little boy, this house, I think, they need no more. They need no more, darling.
It's not for her little boy. She wants a house that she can show off.
So this is bedroom two, then
yeah.
Second.
Daughters Amanda and Tracy. She likes to be called Mandy. The problem centres on Mandy. What's been going on?
It's the way she treats her. She's got an attitude problem.
This is how your daughter Mandy treats her daughter Kayla.
Yeah, she's got an attitude problem towards her. Basically, when she was born, she didn't have that maternal...
Probably not, Tom.
God, I shouldn't have said
that. No, Kayla's fine. So.
And,
And Clive Swift, Dave. I mean, regardless of the... real arse of an interview that he gave afterwards. Clive Swift in Voyage of the Damned is so magical. Right, let's see what a bit of 2006 anniversary looks like. It's a shame that he was such an ass, because I'd have loved to see Mr. Copper come back. Rather than that shoehorned Mr. Copper Foundation.
This Christmas, with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Classic, The Fragrance for Women by Jean-Paul Gaultier.
I don't know if there was ever a firm plan, Dave, but I rather, I mean, I don't think the interview is what tanked it. I think Clive Swift was an arse generally on it.
The Saronno's warm and distinctive taste makes you wish it would never end.
Yeah, so I don't think there was never a set like idea, but I suspect he would have come back when everybody else came back at the end of Series 4.
Big lad, blimey, yeah.
The turkey is. Whereas you've just got this awkward reference to the Mr. Potter Foundation.
It's called Saffron Guild.
It's like, I get what you're doing there, and it's nice that you're trying to include him, but.
And then we've even roasted your vegetables.
No, Mr. Copper Foundation. But like, why would you call it the Mr. Copper Foundation? That's ridiculous.
What is Christmas without
him? I should have got his brother who was in Drop the Dead Donkey.
I'm on my way to play some bingo. We're the number one community.
Sumbingo.co.uk, we love it.
Jimmy Walters at Asda, yeah? Clearly she decided Tesco wasn't for her anymore. No, hang on, that was Prunella Scales. He's got the virus.
Lockets, now with an even bigger soothing centre.
Henry Davenport, right. Remember why you fell. Yeah, there's quite a few things on all four classic sitcoms.
Anthems from Ministry of Sound.
Don't rush around doing your last-minute shopping. This week at Argos, there's up to half price on hundreds of Christmas gifts. Save up to half price on kitchen appliances, an amazing range of audio equipment, and save up to half price on electrical beauty products. Reserve online and then pick up in an instant with quick pay kiosks now.
God, everybody's going online now.
Shop for it, Argos it.
The Lindt Master Chocolatiers demonstrate imagination, passion, creativity, and an infinite love for detail. The result? Swiss tradition chocolates from Lindt. Exquisite masterpieces from the hands of the masters.
The other masters.
Master chocolate here since 1845. Get comfortable this Christmas with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Well, there we go. I want answers.
Amanda out that we're reiterating.
That just seems like a sad tale. There's no winners in that situation, are there? I mean, I was as bad as anyone else watching Jeremy Carlin and laughing at it back in the day. It's. people who go on Jeremy Carl are the ones the woman from yesterday does things for, yeah. Let's hope they never get bored, eh?
Your petty, ridiculous arguments. Yes or no? Yes? Okay, now I'm going to have to go to a break, but here is what's still to come on today's show. You headbutted him.
Yeah.
He's kicked you in the head when you were on the floor.
Yeah.
You've stabbed him.
If you're not compatible, I think it's pretty wrong. You brought two innocent kids into this, don't you?
Blimey. It did surprise me that it took as long as it did for someone to die as a result of the show.
Make the most of your weekend.
Trisha's telly show kind of got out. This is when Jeremy kind of got... Yeah.
Get free unlimited text all weekend. Simply by topping up £10 on a Friday. Text your head off with Top Up Friday from T-Mobile. Around the world, Lexmark helps 75% of the world's top banks and retailers to get more done. And now Lexmark can help you at home too. With a wide range of state-of-the-art wireless inkjet printers, you can print from wherever you work best.
They are, but you know,
put the freedom of
Lexmark, we go to zoos, don't we, ZX?
To work for you.
Are you alive?
Apparently the zoos are still open in a lot of places.
By diesel. Use with caution.
I don't think she found... Last, she found lasting fame, did she? She certainly made it good for a couple of years over there. I have a feeling that the work's dried up. Could be wrong.
Nurofen for children helps make pain and fever disappear. Carvol's unique blend of natural oils helps clear snuffly noses to help your baby.
Actually, I'm dancing on ice now.
It's a Christmas pudding, but with chocolate in it.
Oh, what a torture.
You're going to flambé some red grapes.
Oh, my God. Fabulous.
Now with the chalk.
Sounds like a very posh part.
For the part, you've got to do this 100 times over.
Oh, it's a work of art. You can't eat that. It's too nice. Waters go away.
Yeah, so she had a show from 2012 to 2014.
There you are, my darling. Who hasn't got?
And then since then, yeah, it's been back to kind of guest host on the right stuff for a bit.
Welcome to my Top Gear Interactive Challenge DVD.
Big Brother,
DVD.
Bit on the side, pointless.
You don't have to be a petrolhead to play.
And yeah, dancing on ice, but they were the first couple voted off.
Out now on DVD.
And to Wrinkle Cream?
I think she'd be a bit offended.
Because people can't always agree, there's Pizza Hut's new larger four for all. Four delicious pizzas in one.
Yeah, no, you're right, Dave.
This week only at WH Smith, half price on our best-selling hardbacks. They're going fast. This Christmas, think WH Smith.
BBC advertising on ITV, yeah. I mean, Kat Dealey,
anyone we know?
Once a week she gets, I think, is still over there.
A really big grin on her face.
Chibo is a store like might no other. Been relatively successful.
And a weekly changing range.
I don't know what she's doing
items
now exactly, but she had a Chibo good few years over there. Don't miss this. So she hosts So You Think You Can Dance in the United States.
Any three for the price of two. This week at Chibo.
Which has just been renewed for a 17th season. So,
this Christmas,
yeah, she's doing all right.
Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Yeah, I don't get any nostalgia from these, to be honest.
Perhaps you were put into care or felt unloved as a child.
Not really.
Have you fallen out with a parent because of your childhood? Are you a parent yourself now and cannot understand the way you were treated as a child? Have your parents lied to you about the past?
Talk about bringing it down, Tom.
Do you want to confront them to get the truth? If you do, text the word talk today. We need your name to this number, please. It is 63334, or pick up the phone and call my team. It's
Don't call them, it's been shut down.
Scenario.
I'm assuming this is probably going to be where the tape ends, because I think I'm coming up to the place. And, you know, we could go up at this couple who have stabbed and punched each other, but it's... doesn't feel right anymore, does it? It shames me that it did feel right at one point. To me, anyway, I know, you know, some people were against it from the start. A lot of those. I think I'm done. I'm just gonna check that this is the end of the tape. Yeah, the remaining doors thing has been going around quite a lot, I think, over the last few weeks. Understandably. You'd rather see Mr. Boring again than Jeremy Kyle. Yeah. Well, I don't know if I go that far, but... yeah, no, they are exploitative, you know. Yeah. As I say, they were popular for a reason, you know. I'm one of many people who watched them and got a kind of perverse kick out of laughing at the animals. You know, you say it's a zoo, laughing at the animals. It's, yeah...
sleeps to go until
Christmas
Cox,
that day. Yeah, Anthony Worrell Thompson.
I haven't spotted any shepherds, or wise men for that matter, but I have found three stars to guide us.
Yeah, it did genuinely help some people. I think it harmed more than it helped, but then, you know, if it helped some people, it was kind of worth it. It's, those are people who wouldn't have been able to afford the help otherwise. I think it did more harm than good, but it did do some good, and that's a good thing. Either way, this just isn't the kind of stream where I'm sort of going into that kind of negativity and what, you know, we could watch it and we'd all be going, oh, Jesus. Yeah. Now we'll learn how much help they had. Well, some of them did, some of them didn't. It's, yeah. Anyway. Because, you know, some of them actually got sent off on rehab things and, you know, things that actually helped. But some people was the last reach for help, yeah. Much like, I mean, I think let's end it there, guys. Yeah, thank you all for coming. I will probably be on at some point tomorrow and possibly Monday. You know, depending on how I'm feeling and things. Keep an eye out on the Twitter and all the stuff. All the usual stuff's up there, you all know by now. And yeah, thank you all for coming. I hope you have really good Saturdays, as much as you can. Stay safe, I suppose, and, you know, try and keep calm. Thanks, SPW. See you soon. Yeah, see you, everybody. Bye for now. Actually, I am going. But I think... is Babcock still online? Yes, he is. Oh, and he's got six people. I'm going to send you all to David Babcock. He is a very funny, very angry man. Why is this being bugged? Right, let's raid David Babcock. Raid the David Babcock. Oh. Right, we are raiding Mr. David Babcock. Do hang around, he's great. And he's making a model plane at the moment. Right, I'll see you.
Every time I want a bit of paint, idiot. Hello, Geeky Pete. Oh, God, he's raiding. Sorry. I completely missed that. Hey, Pete. Cheers for the raid, my friend. Oh.